12-year-old getting, it might have been her parents' car parked in front of mine, and she literally had eyelashes, like, what do you call those? Like, just, you know, the ones?
Extensions or, like, eyelash?
You know, like where you strip? Just, a strip, you know, where you just, like, I guess glue or something.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, you're in high school. Like, you should not be wearing that in high school.
Yeah.
Like, that is way too young. Like, maybe if they had, like, a special event that they were going to, like, their sweet 16.
Like a prom or something.
Right. Yeah. But not just, like, to school.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, no.
Yeah, they're growing up a lot faster now.
That is, like, way too fast.
Yeah.
All right, I'm here with Jessica Burciaga. I want to say Jess.
Call me Jess, Jessie, whatever you want.
We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with more.
I just put an 8 in a liter. Throw some Jolly Rancher in, make it sweeter. Versace my clothes, I wear the white hoe, and she snorting 3 lines like Adidas. Got a black girl rolling off Molly. Got a white bitch snorting off snow. Said she want real niggas in the party. Parents gon' leave the keys to the condo. Bitch, close the door. The shit on your nose. She said she want more. She said she want more. So I'ma get more. Yeah, I'ma get more. Bitch, close the door. The shit on your nose. She said she want more. She said she want more. So I'ma get more, yeah, I'ma get more. I just put an 8 in a liter. With a white bitch sniffing on Beaver. Are you sure you wanna party with the demons? Bitch looking for a phone, I ain't seen it. Told Frost, bring the water, no Fiji. Free sticks, I'm pulled up and I'm leaning. I got a couple pussy niggas in their feelings. Cause the main bitch wanna come see me. She said she want more, your girl is a hoe. You need to let go, she fucked on my bros. She snorting the snow, now she touching the toes. She got hand in the cold, all in the nose. If they kick down the door, we gon' get locked for sure. She said she want more. Fuck it. I'ma get more. 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 I'ma get more.
Baby, high life, sleepy, night night. Yeah. Flashes, spotlight, cooler, nice guy. Help it. Peace, peace, beast it.
Yeah.
Bite me,
yeah.
Strike me, indict me. Snipe it, swipe it, drop it. Trouble. I'm lit like Nick White. Bitch, she thick.
Pulled out of the hood, Toyota. Drove back to the hood, Lambo. Crush dance in my soda. Ride, ride city with my eyes closed. Crazy girls got it poppin'. AOD got it poppin'. Tryna text my accountant. Ain't no service in the mountains. Won't you come to the bottom? Know you heard a lot about them. Heard they take that, then they change like a moon ray. I watch them take that, then they change like a moon ray. Pulled out of the hood, Toyota. Drove back to the hood, Lambo. Christians, girls, chance in my soda. Ride, ride city with my eyes closed.
I just put an 8 in a liter. Throw some Jolly Rancher in, make it sweeter. Versace my clothes, I wear the white hoe, and she snorting 3 lines like Adidas. Got a black girl rolling off Molly. Got a white bitch snoring off snow. Said she want real niggas in the party. Parents gon' leave the keys to the condo. Bitch, close the door. The shit on your nose. She said she want more. She said she want more. So I'ma get more. Yeah, I'ma get more. Bitch, close the door. The shit on your nose. She said she want more. She said she want more. So I'ma get more. Yeah, I'ma get more.
And we are back with Jessie Burciaga. My name is Elizabeth Meza, and you're listening to the show. If you guys are working out, make sure you get an extra workout for Jessie and I, because we both decided that we wanted to start working out. I just started with my trainer. Okay. I just started with my trainer last week. I worked out Friday night and Sunday morning. And I did boxing, and that was it. And we normally do like a lot of boxing, kickboxing, but I'm kind of like nursing an injury, leg injury.
Okay.
So I'm doing it like slowly diving in.
Yeah, you got to be careful with those injuries.
But yeah.
Gosh, boxing is such a great workout.
Oh my God.
I feel like I'm so badass. Not just, it's a fun workout.
Yeah.
Like when you're in a gym, it's a little bit more, ugh. But when I'm boxing, I know it's fun.
It's like, so much
something.
Fun. Yeah. It's like such a mental therapy.
Yeah.
And if you guys didn't know, but I'm sure you already know, Jessica Burciaga is Miss February 2009. And I wanted to ask you before we got dove into like other stuff, you know, for a while, like Playboy had changed the magazine. Like they decided that they wanted to kind of do it more kind of mainstream, and they wanted to take the nudity out of it. They were going to just do it without nudity. How do you feel about that?
Well, when I heard about that, I thought, I don't know, you know, like it just seems that that's Playboy.
Yeah.
It's like a classic, like legendary magazine that shows women like the most beautiful way that they could be shown.
Right.
So to take that away, it's like just to put regular modeling photos. You can go on Instagram to see that, you know, like I don't, I didn't see why they would do that, but I heard it did okay.
Yeah.
But I think they brought it back to being nude again, didn't they?
I think I did hear something about that, but you're right. It's like when I first heard it, I just, I was like, why are they doing that? It's like Playboy. That's not what Playboy is. Like they're taking away from what it originally was and is, you know?
That's what I thought. And it's just, like I said before, I think the market's oversaturated with sexy women all over the place.
Yeah.
So maybe they felt like they were losing business because you can Google on your phone and see naked women and Instagram and it's everywhere. So it probably wasn't doing as well as it was, you know, 20 years ago, 30 years ago.
Like the print magazine. So maybe that's what they were doing, like online only.
Right.
But, you know, how do you, like I noticed that like on your Instagram, like with a lot of the girls, like social media, there's like a lot of stuff that they promote. You know, a lot of products. Is that how you make your money?
Yeah, that's part of it. Besides from my business with the hair extensions and Sailor and Saint, I guess a social media influencer, as I've been hearing. Yeah, you know, before I think you had to go on auditions and run around town to try to get booked for a job, you know. And because of social media, these companies email us now and say, hey, you know, let's send, I'll send you some product and, you know, give me your rate and you post for them. And it's like an ongoing business. It's been going on for years and I've done really well. I know a lot of girls are doing really good, especially makeup bloggers, beauty bloggers. It's been like a life-changing experience for a lot of girls that are, they get to travel all over the world, do reviews on different hotels, stay there for free and get paid and then do a review on the hotel and take photos and promote the hotel. So that's another way. It's just endless what you can do.
And like for you, I guess it would, it's nice because then you, like you said, you don't have to go on auditions anymore. You can just do it out of your home.
Yeah, you just,
that's really nice.
Answer your emails for you and like, hey, do you want to do this job? Do you want to do that one? No, you know.
How do you go about choosing the type of products that, you know, once they pitch them to you that you want to definitely, you know, post them and talk about them?
Actually, you can probably see too from my Instagram that I don't do a lot of that anymore because I kind of started looking at like my page looks like an ad for everything.
Yeah.
Like I'm sponsoring all these things, you know. So I kind of like stopped it and just promoted my own clothes and my Burciaga blends for a while. But, you know, I got back into it because I'm like, oh, what's so bad about it? And I realized that I just have to find products that I actually like and want to sell to my followers and my fans, especially the women, because they really rely on you to, they look up to you and they think you have beautiful skin or your pretty hair. So they're trusting you to, you know, tell them the truth.
Right.
So I've tried certain things before and I'm like, this lipstick is trash. I am not promoting this, you know, and I won't. And then I have a bunch of like stuff at home, boxes I've never used.
Yeah.
And there's other products that, you know, I had a good relationship with the company and I'm like, oh, this is actually a really good product. I like this. And that's how I post. And I think some people think you're lying. Like when I say, I've really tried this, like these hair vitamins actually work, you know. They're like, yeah, right, she's getting paid for this. But, you know, can I just talk about this really fast?
Yeah.
People were looking down upon all these girls promoting. Did you hear about that? Like, just, you could just see people getting irritated, like girls constantly promoting something on social media, like instead of just, you know, posting modeling pictures.
Yeah.
And the comments I would see, like, you know, you're just getting paid for this. Like, you're lying and you don't really use this product. I'm like, okay, so when you watch, when you're sitting at home and you see a commercial come on and Jennifer Lopez comes out on a L'Oreal commercial and says, buy this hair dye because that's how she got her hair color. Like, do you actually think J-Lo dyed her hair? with L'Oreal box dye, but you're buying it, right? And all these other celebrities that say they're using, you know, L'Oreal mascara and all these things. It's like you think that they're using it, but they're not. Like,
no.
I mean, I don't think, I mean, I personally think J-Lo and Beyonce and all these women have professional hairstylists.
Yeah.
But, you know, to me, that's the same thing. Like, you know, they use celebrities to market their product. It's the same thing, you know?
Yeah. You know, I honestly don't think there's nothing wrong with whatever you want to promote on social media. I think it's to each his own. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, it's a way of making money. You have to make money some way or the other.
Yeah, it's like you might as well make money if you're going to be on social media.
Yeah.
Posting pictures. So you want a half-naked photo of a girl for no reason? Or do you want her, like, holding up a teeth whitening and she paid, like, you know, $5,000 from the post or something, you know?
Yeah.
Like, might as well post and get paid instead of posting for free.
Yeah. You know, I don't know if you'd still do this, but you used to promote that tea. Wasn't there like a tea? Was it fit, not fit tea?
It might have been fit tea. I've done a couple teas. A fit tea, a bow, boo tea. There's a boo tea.
Did you ever like those teas?
Yeah, you know what?
Because I've seen like a bunch of girls, like there's this one tea that everyone promotes.
Oh,
like
skinny mint tea? Protein World? Oh, that's not a tea. That's a protein shake.
That's one. Protein World. I've seen all the girls promote that. And I always wonder, is it really good?
Or flat tummy tea.
Flat tummy
tea. That's the one I've seen everywhere, too.
Yeah.
I think they all pretty much do the job.
The same thing.
I've tried all of them. They all work the same. I think they do work for its purpose. It's not going to make you lose, like, 100 pounds. But I think it gets rid of your bloating.
Yeah.
Like, when I feel, like, bloated.
Then you take it.
Yeah, you, like, you know, make the tea in the morning, drink it, and it, you know, flushes you out. And it definitely, you know,
gives you that skinny effect
to you. Yeah. So don't leave the house for like an hour.
You know what? Speaking of taking things, I just started doing the whole apple cider vinegar.
Oh, yeah. That's great.
And I've had people on Facebook ask me, and I was like, okay, I cannot answer what it exactly does, because I only did it because one of my guests, you know, I had Lisa Ann on my show, and she said that she was taking it, and she said, you know, she notices a difference. And when I kind of briefly read up on it, you know, it gives you energy, and it's supposed to, you know, it helps make you feel good. Mm-hmm. So I started taking it, but when somebody asked me on social media, I was like, oh, I cannot answer that, because I don't know exactly, but I know you've taken it before.
Oh, yeah. I really believe in apple cider.
Okay, so can you, like, tell, like, the listeners exactly, like, what that is for?
I grew up on this stuff because
really?
My grandpa is, like, a health nut. Like, that's all he drank his whole life, and that's all he would give us, and we hated it when we were younger.
Really? So he would give it to you when you were younger?
Oh, my gosh. We would go, like, out. We'd go to Disneyland, and then he would bring all the apple cider vinegar. But he used to work with this doctor, and they used to make their own with, like, herbs and stuff, mm-hmm. like, with this medicine man kind of guy.
Yeah.
And it was, like, a real, real apple cider vinegar that they made, and he would put, like, a few teaspoons in water.
Yeah.
At the dinner table at a nice restaurant. And we're like, Grandpa, we want soda. We want apple juice. Like, we were little kids.
Yeah.
He's like, no. Can we get 5 waters? And then he would put the apple cider vinegar and make us drink it. And so that taste to me is so, like, normal to me. It doesn't, like, affect me. Like, some people go, oh, how do you drink that? I'll take a shot of it in the morning, like a shot glass.
Of the
apple cider vinegar.
It's straight?
Just straight.
But I thought I heard that it's not good, you know, if it's straight, because it could,
I don't know. It's too good for you? I mean, my grandpa always says I should mix it in water.
Yeah, because it would be too harsh, like, in your, like, the layering of your stomach.
Right. It could, because it is kind of, ooh, you know, you get that in your stomach, you get
a
little
like
nauseous.
Acidity.
Yeah, you get a little, ooh.
But what is it for? Like, is it, like, to give you energy, and what else?
I think it has so many benefits. I think, for one thing, you can drop weight. I was just talking about this with my cousin, Donna, the other day. She was telling me, she's like, oh, my gosh, cousin, I just got on this, and I lost 10 pounds already in the month.
Wow.
And she didn't even change her diet. She just said she started walking more and drinking the apple cider vinegar in the morning and mixing it in her hot tea.
Yeah.
And when I take it, I have the same effects. It gives me energy. My skin clears up and gets more, like, shiny and, like, dewy.
Yes.
So energy, good skin. weight loss.
Mm-hmm.
I think it has a lot of benefits. Yeah.
That's interesting. Yeah. All right. So I am here.